AP180005, that's the last one. I make a motion that we open the public hearing for AP180005. Is there a second?
Second.
Got a second. All those in favor?
This request involves an appeal of an administrative decision of the Forsyth County Department of Planning and Community Development.
Mr. Bose, opening statement.
So, this property is 3450 Bentwood Drive, and this appeal number 180005 is for this property, which already has a conditional use permit for an equestrian center. And all equestrian centers have a caretaker facility of some sort or the other. It's just part of the facility and nature of the business. And we had one too. We had a trailer. And you heard previous testimony that the trailer was removed for refurbishment. And when I went to bring it back for the electrical permit, it started everything here. So then I went ahead and applied for the residential permit. And which again, I do need not have to do because it was already there. It should have been grandfathered, and they should have allowed me to get the trailer back, and I wouldn't have done anything with anything else. So when they disallowed the trailer, I had to apply for this residential permit, and I should not have to. And that is the entire argument, which is I submitted the application package with all the residential permit that is that was accepted but not processed. And had that been done, then it just makes it would have eliminated so much of this headache with going through the whole cup process and all that to do the exact same thing. And that's all.
Properties LLC is appealing the rejection of a building permit by the planning department in February 2018. Run through these. Okay, my eyes are getting tired, I gotta get closer. The decision being appealed is a decision to reject the residential additions permit application for the building addition of caretaker's residence based on a stop work notice for an alleged MRPA violation, period. So the decision is whether or not the county can reject a building permit application or a residential caretaker residential addition permit application based on the existence of a stop work order on the property. What's the best way to figure that out? Let's go to the code. If we look at the UDC, in the record is Exhibit 1, Section UDC 5-3.6. The director, list some other people that can do this. The director is actually defined as the director of planning and community development. The director of engineering, or the director of water and sewer, or their agents are hereby authorized and directed to deny and withhold permits on any new project or applicant pursuant to this code where the applicant applicant's business or agent has failed or refused to comply with county requirements or regulations specified by this code. In other words, there's some violation, hence the stop work order. Therefore, the director is directed to deny and withhold permits. Gentlemen, that pretty much answers it. For the record, we're going to introduce brief evidence that there would be other grounds for rejecting this permit. One is the fact that the property is inappropriately zoned. It doesn't have a cup. It needs to get that cup. Now, we've heard testimony that that cup is in process, scheduled to be heard July 5th, but as of the date that that application for a caretaker residence was submitted, that cup still has not yet been approved. So it couldn't have been issued in the first place. Also, UDC 7-2.5 says no building permit shall be issued for a commercial or industrial project or amenities area for a residential subdivision unless there is an active site development permit for the project. I think we've heard this is an amenities area for a subdivision. The horse farm is within the Chattahoochee River Club, the horse stables are within the Chattahoochee River Club subdivision. Based on this, I will put the bridge in, but those two sections, the one section that says the director is directed to deny permits answers the questions in this case. That'll be the end of it. Thank you.
Mr. Bose.
Yeah.
Any evidence to present?
Oh, yeah. You saw it.
What do you want to do with it?
Which one? What do you want to do? That's it. Yeah. That's it.
Okay, what's this?
As a letter, basically summarizing what I'm saying.
You can argue your case here, yeah. If that's what you want. This isn't.
This is it.
Testify that you received this email. Is that the idea?
Yes. That shows the application. And the application.
No objection to the application in this case. It needs to be tendered in evidence. I think it's part of the record anyway, but that's fine.
Okay.
I have an objection to the Ms. Farrell's email. Thank you. Votes.
Two documents?
Yeah. All right. I have to wait for it once.
I'm not sure. He's got the documents identified, it's signed by him. Look, appears to be the original letter identified. Letter of appeal. I'm not sure what its purpose is with respect to this particular appeal.
That's it, just the.
Just two documents.
Yeah.
The application and the letter from Ms. Farrell.
Yes, and my letter.
Would you like to that needs some basis on what the appeal, the letter of appeal is intended to be?
Oh, it summarizes all the OCGs that we have here. So I'm writing this letter to the board.
Is it from?
It's from me to the process.
It's from you to do?
For all five appeals, I have one letter covering
to the board.
Yeah.
Okay. Deny that.
Okay.
I'll read it. I'll admit the other two documents.
Okay. So on this appeal here, I had to see the very nature of the business does not require any change in zoning for residents or needing a building permit or anything else to have a caretaker residence on the property, and that's the entire basis of the appeal. And again, it starts with the stop work order, and it is in this emails and this evidence.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Actually, I do have a question for you, Bose.
Okay.
The deal, please.
All right. Any evidence about the county?
I can't expand on the evidence of the exhibits in the Unified Building Code. Thank you.
Okay. Anyone here who wishes to speak in favor of or in opposition to the application?
In opposition.
Good morning. My name is John Richards. I live at 3530 River Club Drive, Chattahoochee River Club. I've been a Forsyth County resident for 1999. I'm here because of my concerns about what's been going on in the equestrian center, and also as a representative of the Chattahoochee River Club, HOA, since I'm on the board. I'm going to refer to Chattahoochee River Club as CRC from here on, cut out all the long stuff. All of you should have received a letter from the law firm, yes, someone here, setting forth our concerns and our legal concerns about violations on the property. I'm not going to get into the legalese of that, but let me give you a little history if I can, and I'll try to keep you awake and then out of here quick. CRC started development in 1995 as a 702-acre development with approximately 628 home sites. That development was made possible by a land swap with the U.S. Park Service, U.S. Forest Service, and Silver Creek Development. Today, there are 624 finished homes with over 2,000 residents in CRC. In 1995, the developer CRC took three community parcels totaling about 18.4 acres and put them into an equestrian facility development. In 1995, Forsyth County zoned this 18.4 acre equestrian facility as CBD with two conditions. One, shall be used for equestrian purposes only. Two, no retail sales other than those related to the equestrian center will be allowed. On January 21st, 1999, a trail system easement agreement was recorded between the Edgewood Properties and Silver Creek Development, which were the developers and the owners, and the United States of America, the operating divisions at that time would be the Park Service and the Forest Service. That agreement established into perpetuity, certain restrictions on the equestrian center property, mainly that it was to be operated only as an equestrian center, and certain easements were granted in the riding trails, access points, and use of the equestrian center barn, paddocks, and parking areas. This property was and is intended as an access point for not only CRC residents, but also the public at large to access the horse trails for use and enjoyment in the community and in the protected adjacent wetland. Because of this agreement, CRC spends thousands of dollars each year maintaining approximately 2.5 miles of trails and access points in CRC, as well as trails and bridges in the Bowman National Forest around CRC. And this equestrian center has been sold twice. Once in 2001 and of late 2005. Both those sales were subject to this 1999 trail system easement agreement. In October 2016, Mommies Property submitted a rezoning app for Site County to convert the property from equestrian office to a quote, recreational facility for sports and exercise, close quote, namely yoga lessons and classes. At the December 2016 annual meeting of CRC, 100% of the attending residents, which represented a quorum, voted 100% against any change from equestrian only. Mommies Property eventually withdrew their application. In October of 2017, Mommies Property submitted CP 170014 to build a 2,500 square foot caretaker's residence on the second floor of the barn. We now are aware of AP180005 that the request has changed from one 2,500 square foot residence to two residences with a total of three bedrooms, three bathrooms, and two kitchens. The CRC HOA does not oppose a county-approved construction of one caretaker's residence of between 900 and 1,000 square feet to be occupied only by the caretaker slash stable manager and without a rental charge. Now currently, residents and neighbors have reported the following activities on this property. Heavy deforestation, that's confirmed by comparison of Google Maps from 2015 to 2018. I think we have those maps, but I'll ask that we hold those until I get through the presentation. And then if you'd like to see the maps, we can put them up on the screen. That'll get going. I know you want to get through here. In addition, truckloads of dirt, cement, wood studs, wood posts, steel I-beams, electrical and plumbing supplies have been delivered to the equestrian center, with work being done all hours of the day and night. As a matter of fact, the owner principal of Mommy's properties, Vinay, Bose, has visited neighborhood homes and apologized to the residents for the construction noise being generated from this work. Other residents have reported work being done inside the barn, including pouring concrete foundations, wood supports, glass viewing areas, installation of the TMI beams in the ceilings, and so on. There's been additional land disturbance in the front, sides, and rear of the barn, including enlarging a drain area with a culvert, thereby increasing the water flow to Hawk Creek, which empties into the Chattahoochee River. We're advised that approximately one half of the horse stalls have been removed to make room for an archery venue complete with viewing areas and targets. There's been destruction of certain trails and paths used by CRC residents and the public at large. And gentlemen, none of these violations of deforestation, land disturbance, interior construction, modification actions have anything to do with pasteurization set forth in Mommy's Properties Appeal. Our concerns about some of these activities were communicated to the Forsyth County Planning Commission on October 2017. I would suggest that if all or any part of the above work is taking place as reported, CRC HOA is calling upon Forsyth County to inspect this unpermitted work, because the work may have been performed in an unsafe manner, putting employees and the public at risk with construction failures and imposing certain financial and legal liabilities on Forsyth County. Therefore, we're asking the zoning board's denial of Mommy's Properties Appeal of 18005. We'll also be demanding Mommy's Properties open their gates 7 days a week at reasonable hours so that the CRC residents and the public can access those trails and paths and parking areas as set forth in the easement agreement recorded in 1999. If you need to see the aerials, I'm happy to show them to you. If you need it, you've seen a lot of it. All these aerials show is the amount of deforestation that's taking place on this property from 15 to 18. Would you pull up that first one on 15, please?
Yes. If you look where the rink, the riding rink is, the half moon, yeah, you'll see the trees that are obstructing part of that. You'll see the trees on the side of the barn. Thanks. You see the trees on, is it working?
Yep.
You'll see the trees on the side of the barn. You'll see all the trees in the back and over on the other side. The next one, if you would, please. Now, all of a sudden, those trees are gone. They've been clear cut on the sides, in the back, and in the front. Nothing has to do with pasteurization with those trees being taken down. Any questions?
Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else like to speak in opposition to the application? Mr. Bose, Mr. Frickey, you both have an opportunity to present any evidence you wish to rebut the statement from that you just heard.
Take the order. He's up there. In all honesty, I don't believe the concern. While I'm sympathetic in the extreme to the concerns, I believe the issue, and I'll try to get this probably over the head a few too many times, but the issue on this appeal is a very specific one, whether the county director of planning and community development was authorized to reject an application for the caretaker resident based on the issue, the existence of a stop work order, and I think we've just shown that it was, so I don't believe while concerning, I don't believe the testimony added any evidence to that particular question, so we're comfortable with what we said.
Rose, do you have anything more to add?
When we started with how this is motivated by Chattel Chiripo Club, and they have 619 homeowners there, and we have issues with them. He's wrong on plenty of things there, and so there's no point going into any of that with the reference to this particular appeal. Thank you.
Closing argument.
I mean, I forgot how we still had that to go. Gentlemen, I will make it short and sweet. The code says that the director is not only authorized but directed to reject any appeals that come in with this violation of property. In this case, it was clear there was not only one but two stop work orders on the property, and the director made an absolutely correct decision to reject that application. On top of that, as we showed the code, the Unified Development Code requires that a cup be in existence and that a site development permit be in place. Neither of those took place. Therefore, the decision to reject the residential caretaker application was absolutely correct, was not clearly erroneous, and the board should affirm the county's decision. Thank you very much.
Pretty much what I've said before, I should not have to go through this part of the application process, and they put me through that as well, but go with whatever you all are judging today. Thank you.
That concludes the public hearing. The board should move to close the public hearing and certainly ask any questions it desires.
No limiting questions at this point?
I may have missed something. You were talking earlier about a trailer on the property.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
And it had to be removed.
Yes, sir. It wasn't removed. I mean, we took it out. It wasn't removed for repairs and, rehab.
Is it back then?
No, they didn't let me bring it back.
They didn't.
They did not let me bring it back. It was there for 20 years. I wish they did that.
There's one there now.
No, sir.
There's a trailer on your property now.
Oh, no. That's my friend's, which is wrecked. This is a residential trailer that was parked. I can show you on a picture, but I don't
answer right now.
Where the electrical line was going?
Don't worry about it.
That's where it was parked.
And the other question is, and it probably isn't relevant to this particular application, but the gates are locked. How are these people supposed to be able to use the riding trails? Just out of curiosity, when you bought the property, there were easements and they have some rights, but you locked the gate. I'm confused.
That's a fantastic question.
Well, do you have a fantastic answer for me?
Yes, the premise of your question itself is wrong. That's why it's fantastic. So,
You're subscribing to the notion that there are easements and trails that belong to child which you go to on the property.
No, that they have the right to use.
Right, same thing. They don't.
That's an argument. That's an argument between him and CRC.
Not we are here with all these appeals because of that. Yeah,
it's not relevant.
Yeah, it's not.
We won't consider that.
For this appeal, it's not. But it's relevant because that's what brought me here.
Are there other questions? I make a motion that we close the public hearing for AP18005.
Second.
Here a second. Got a second? All those in favor? Unanimous. Any discussion? Prior to the motion.
Mr. Chairman, I move that the board affirm the county's decision for appeal application AP180005.
The motion, do I hear a second?
Second.
Now, second. In discussion. All those in favor of approving the motion. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the meeting for yesterday and today.
I will
make a motion to adjourn the meeting.
I second.
All of in favor?
Everybody be careful. I'm going to sleep on my desk.
You might as well. Is this count as 2 minutes? Got mine.
I can't.